Hey, welcome everybody to Battle Pirates Crib. Tonight we're mostly going to talk about the Outpost 14 upgrade. And despite what Derpy may whisper in your ear, you cannot use base parts to upgrade anything associated with OP-14, anything prior to OP-14. Yes, you can use base parts to upgrade, but you know, just watch out when he tries to whisper in your ear. So let's say hello to everybody. Derpy?
Did I hear someone add some base parts? I could use a few more. I'm only at 1.4 million.
Okay. All righty. And Pegleg.
Christ almighty, what is with everybody in these damn base parts? You know you can't do it. It's been this way forever. Quit being a bunch of trolling monkeys.
Yeah. Well, it did happen about 3 years ago, but yeah. For what, like a couple of hours? Because I think that update happened at like midnight.
Yes.
And most people slept through it, but for the people, at least midnight on the East Coast in the U.S., or even later, it was really late at night. So a lot of people missed it, but people were able to, 3 or 4 years ago, were able to upgrade their OP and whatever else using base parts. So some people skipped ahead of the line, but this is not the case this year. So yeah, they're not your friend, Zach. So we'll just leave it at that. But we will get into, if you use some of my past recommendations, I'm already working on my doc, so we will talk about that, but it'll be a lot of what I said a while ago. So let's move ahead. All right, general bug fixes. So if anybody wants to come up with a better guy to be general bug fixes, send it along to me. I just couldn't find any more that. There was one that did have the Confederate flag on that I decided not to use, the General Lee with a that has a Volkswagen bug, but I decided against that one. So we can move forward. All righty. Right now we have Outpost 14. New FM target. VXP weekend is going to drop on Friday. From the Shadows, which is for the Assassin. So most people should be caught up. And then the Power Play TLC, which we will get into. We have a slide on that. Next week is Bounty. The Crucible TLC, which will be for the Purifier. Tear in the Deep for the Lionfish, which might be worth it, or we'll get into that. I think when we talk about the Power Play TLC. And then we have Jaws of the Beast, which is for the Winter Fang, which got moved from this week to next week. I'm assuming so people couldn't have, that didn't have the Winter Fang, could have the Winter Fang before Bounty. But maybe I'm just being a conspiracy theory person on that one. Any thoughts on the calendar, anybody?
Yeah, I'm not too sure if that's the reason they moved it or not. They didn't give a reason, but that's as plausible as any.
Yeah.
Well, the assumption that I am working with is that they just gave us a whole crap ton of base defense upgrades, and the idea is we should probably do those first before we get the prizes in that thing. And it says the cryo weapon, which we've all been expecting for the past few months, so they probably don't want to release those until we've had the chance to at least coin a year worth of upgrades.
Okay. Alrighty. Yeah, yeah, cause, or you could just buy a 28-day bubble. But
I'm thinking about it.
There are a few of those out there.
Yeah. So, all right. Let's move forward. What does it mean we will be allowed? I don't know. And I forgot.
I doubt we're getting increased winter fang capacity.
Yeah. And I'm right now, I'm looking weapons. Power Play has a heavy halo missile as a prize twice. They did not increase the capacity at all for that either. So it's still stuck at 3. I was wondering if there was some potential they might increase that to 4, but they did not. Right now we have the Power Play TLC, which is, we assume, the same targets as Brutal Instinct, because you're supposed to, there are lionfish targets, but this time you don't get to do them under half repair conditions.
And it was bad enough under half repair.
Yeah. So, unless they made some adjustments, this is not going to be, a walkthrough TLC. So prize pack 1 is all stuff that you could do with base parts if you're not already caught up. Prize pack 2, some amount of base parts, some amount of titanium, but you do get another heavy halo missile. Again, the limit is 3. You get a Draconian ice wall, and then more stuff related to OP-13. And the same thing in Price Pack 3, where they replace it with the Reaver Firewall. I thought those two would be switched, to be honest. The two.
I did too.
The ice wall is better than the firewall.
Slightly, yeah.
Much better.
Yeah, and was released prior. So that would have been my assumption. But and again, we get more stuff that was associated with OP-13. And again, more base parts and titanium that you could earn on auto in a couple of minutes. And then up to 5 3-day defense platform structure build tokens. This is, each one is enough to get one defense platform from 13 to 14. And then the grungy gunners evade and splash and whatnot crew that
it's the new top defense crew, which still doesn't mean a whole lot.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. All right, I'm making my decision now, so I don't have to deal with this is an experiment. Next week or Friday, only subscribers are going to be able to
participate in the chat.
Yeah, because this is and we'll see if that does anything. If it doesn't do anything, I'll take that setting off. But we've been getting too much of the Russian hackers or just putting
bots or whatever they are. Yeah.
So yeah, and I can imagine with the new players, as you said last week. it's quite amusing. But, I could imagine doing this, the Brutal Instinct TLC with the Gift Lionfish. That wouldn't be good. Because I know, Derpy, you had issues trying to auto the.
Yep, you literally can't auto it, which is kind of dumb. I think I probably need to make Kixi a flowchart for them to test. And step 1 will be: is this an auto target? Yes. Can you auto it? If the answer is no, redesign it. It shouldn't be that hard.
No, it shouldn't.
Whatever.
Yeah.
I will point out that I know that at least TSM put a video out, and I think there was another one or two where they used a combo of a lionfish as a tank decoy for damage, and the brutes behind it with a little bit of more involved driving. to keep their damage down in doing this. But that's not going to be for everybody because of the amount of driving slash skill factor.
Yeah. So, but I would still recommend, especially if you don't have all of the heavy halos or the ice walls that you may need, it's still going to be a good idea no matter what, even though it seems like a lot of work to get five turrets upgraded. It's still a useful TLC. It's not a complete waste of your time, even though it is a, as we expect, it's the Brutal Instinct targets without half repair. It's going to be, you can get it done. It's just a matter of, you know, you're having to hit this 8 times and then repair. I'm still repairing from Brutal Instinct that I did today because I didn't get them. Well, I could have gotten them all done during the raid, but I would have wasted too many potential lionfish tokens. So I waited to do one today and way more time because you don't have the ability to fix as many fleets while you're doing it in the mastery round.
Right.
Because you have the double repair. So it becomes a lot more damage at the end of once you're done with the campaign. All right.
Just going to mention too, back when I was, when he did this thing before and it was a problem, we said, you know, you shouldn't have to do it, but I did a lot of taking out the halo with rockets.
Yeah.
You might want to consider the value of doing that with those, and you don't need the top level rocket. You're one down from it. So it's a couple hours each.
The other thing that I did do, even if you can't, switch around your, I guess it would all work out at the end. But what I was doing was after I came back, I would switch around because what happens is once your flagship, because there's a king killer mechanism in here.
Right.
Once your flagship reaches the armor of the rest of your ships, it's going to start attacking the second ship. So I would put whichever one has the highest survival in that spot the next time. And then after the next encounter, you might want to switch another ship, but it probably all works out in the wash. I don't know if that was necessary, but I would make sure if you have a mix of higher and lower upgrade levels, you know, U3 versus X1, I would put I'm just going to use the X1 and U3. I would put the X1s in the higher, in the 1, 2, 3 slots, and then the lower ones in the 4 and 5 slot, because that first ship is going to get targeted. Even if it's in the second position, if the first ship now has less health than the second ship. So you would prefer to have that higher survival ship in that place as opposed to one with a lower one. So just a thought there. All right. If there's no more on power play,
all right. Move on.
All right. We have one new target, one new target name. I'm not sure who came up with this idea. The 194 is now called the 213. Because it gives away more points, but it's, you know, and the way it read was basically whatever, we can change the name just to keep the points in line. I don't think that makes sense. If next week the 213 goes back to being the 194,
yeah, but it won't. It will stay the 213, right?
That's my impression. But
well, why? Because if they've okay, so the next target is going to be the lower ranked target. Okay, yeah. So yeah, I don't like them. I would rather them just keep them
maybe,
where they are.
Or maybe. Excuse
yeah. Me. Go ahead. Okay, but yeah, the 213 is the same as the 194 that we had last month. It just has a different number. I would have rather just waited a month and let them figure it out. But the 186 is still around. The 223
is the new one.
It's the new one.
I can't talk. My throat hurts. Never mind.
Okay. Take a breather for a moment. I do have some early feedback on the 223 from a Battle Pirates mate of mine. He said the 223 is quick. He did 11 of them before his fleet died, but that took care of the FM. He was using 4 of them with full armors, all new, and a total of 12 or 13 of those new Knuckle Dragger rockets.
So on the contrast side, I autoed it with my fleet, which has no changes whatsoever, and got 3 hours damage. Okay. I was attempting to say earlier, before I tried to eat something sharp, that I bet the next month we get the old Lionfish 212 replaced by like the 233 or something that gives out 150K. That's my guess.
Could be.
Yeah. Yeah, Kraken Duck, I think he's got some updates to his. I think he sent me earlier, he was getting like 2 hours and 21 minutes autoing, but I'm assuming he has some upgrades to his, newer. I know I have all new armors on all mine, and I still have... I have 10 of the knuckle dusters on, and I have 5 yet to fit.
So did you drop a rocket to fit those armor?
Yeah.
Is that what you did? Okay.
I dropped a rocket and went from, I went down to, damn it, what's the rocket reload?
Cluster warheads?
Cluster warheads. I went from 3 to 2 because it really doesn't make a difference. It's like 2.23 versus 2.2.
Sure.
So that's the change I made. KB was driving it for around an hour. So that lines up with what you were saying, Pegleg, as far as him doing, he was able to do, you said 11, or he was able to finish everything. So
yeah, finished the FM, did 11 of those. He did feel that the points to damage ratio is still better on the 213, but.
Okay.
Takes longer. The 223 are very fast.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, I haven't yet to look at that target. I'm still,
Me either.
Yeah, I'm still got things repairing from the Brutal Instinct TLC. So let's move on. We got a lot to cover. Sanctification CIC.
Or also known as the Armored Minnow.
Yeah, or, something that looks a lot like the Purifier ship with a few more rounded edges. But it appears to be pretty good as far as some of our fears. The only thing I wish it did was increase range, but it adds combat speed, building damage, radioactive damage, adds evade, and
splash damage reduction. Look at that.
Look at that.
A whole 2000 based on a tier 11 chip. That's almost as much as the amount of information we get from forums, like a ton.
It's pissing in the wind, you know it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And I think there's a major clue regarding the targets is I was just reading off the aura stats. But you see that there is an additional 50% wall damage, which...
There's going to be walls. There's going to be stone walls everywhere.
Yes. So, yeah, I mean...
That wall damage stat only applies to the ship it's equipped to, correct?
Yes, yes. The other ones are auras. But that is, just the ship that it's equipped to. So, still, it takes to complete the FM... It only takes 10 of the highest targets, which is...
Oh, that's a lot of them autoing.
Yeah, well, I mean, if you can drive them and get them all done in, an hour.
Sitting. Yeah, that's not bad.
Yeah. But if you're going to, auto 186s, it may get to you. So that is understandable. But they're trying to drive the train that you hit the newest target. So you're able to get 2 of these. They're 560,000 or
516, isn't it?
518. Yeah, I was gonna come and put this on later because I was with the fact that it's with the way that the ratings get released, it's sort of a pain in the ass for days like today when there is a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah, it is 560K, by the way.
560.
Yeah, it's 560. Where there's really nothing in the briefing. And then, so you're left without, after the update, you have to put everything together, which is a bit annoying.
Hey, at least you got it done. I didn't get it done and changed for the TFC post. So I suck, apparently.
Yeah. So, okay. But definitely worth getting. You can get two at 560 each. So best of luck. And this can only be equipped on U1 purifiers. Even though it says Siege, I'm willing to bet we're not going to have a CIC on our next Siege ship. But could be wrong. All right.
But can I put it on an older one?
With the weight of that?
And it would only give the wall damage because the bonus effect is Siege Purifier.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it would seem a little expensive just for that. So, all right, let's move on. All right, Outpost
topic
14.
Of the day.
Yep. So,
you know what you don't see on this slide? Base parts. There's no base parts on this.
We don't even know what base parts look like. So that could be what's like dripping from those third and fourth.
That weird gooey stuff.
Yeah, that could be base parts or the splatter. I don't know. That could be base parts because we've never really seen them before. So. All right.
But the picture of base parts is just a bunch of titanium nuts laying around. So,
yeah,
there you go.
All right, Outpost 14. You need to do this before you do anything else. It's 21 days, 14 hours, a bunch of uranium and resources. It unlocks everything out. Well, it doesn't unlock everything, but pretty much. You need this to even get started. So,
yep.
Doubles the armor. And it a substantial increase in power production.
And keep in mind, the 21-day, 14-hour time is with an officer. There are players out there that don't have officers, and then you're staring at 24 days.
Can we change factions even during its upgrade? I'm not certain.
Well, if mine's currently upgrading, I can click a button and see if something happens.
See if it at least gives you the option.
It looks like I can. I'm not going to spend 150 gold to try it, but it does appear that it gives me the option.
Okay.
I bet it works. I can start an R&D for the research for a VXP Conqueror token. I can tell you that.
And that's tied to that same outpost function. So
yeah. I'll bet you can probably switch.
Yeah,
28. I'm sure.
Yeah, I do have an officer with what I'm showing here, Zach. But 28 days sounds excessive because it's only a 10% reduction. So, I'm not certain on that number.
No, I said 24.
I'm look at the screen. I'm Zach saying 28.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, 24 with no officer and the 21 and change, whatever, with. So.
Okay. All right. I've already started upgrading my dock.
How do you get your outpost down?
Well, I kept the five-day upgrade token.
The five-day?
Yeah, that goes back quite a ways, but yeah, there was a five-day.
Yeah, there was a five-day, like, right after the release of OP-13.
Well, I probably used that on OP-13.
Yeah, and I was like, no, I'm going to save mine because I don't see a purpose for it because it was released after. Okay. And then I had 5 2-day tokens. I still had points left over from the for the raid. So that was 5 days plus 10 days, so 15 days. Plus, and then it became 17 days. And then I had
3 1-day probably.
Yeah, 3 1-day. So I'm at 20. And then I had 6 unique 1-day tokens. And I used 2 of them. And done. So the unique are old. I, you know, I'm stingy with some of these ones because I'm afraid of a shipyard upgrade one day.
Right.
So I've kept a lot of those things just to be extra tokens, but that got it all taken care of. I could have waited. I actually spent a 1-day unique build token on a 12-hour upgrade just because of the fact that, as far as I know at this point, and it seems to be confirmed with other things that I've seen, if your outpost gets leveled, it's not gonna continue to upgrade. So that's a 12-hour vacation. Yes, vacation that your outpost upgrade workers are taking. So this seemed to be, to me, the most crucial one for my interest to rush along.
I would agree with that assessment. You want to get the outpost done as soon as possible because that takes 12 hours to repair and your dock takes like 2. So if you get flat every 36 hours and your dock's upgraded and only adds 2, but your OP will increase that a ton. Okay. Some people might want to use all the tokens they have. If you have 7 days left, it might be worth buying a 7-day bubble. Might not. You have to decide.
There also are 2 different TLOs out currently. Not that I'm advising anybody to spend money, but, you know, consider your options. The one is 16 days worth. It's, I think it's 8 2-day tokens. That's discounted. I think it was 60% of my memory. And then there's a 4-day, 2x2-day, I think it is. You can buy up to twice, and that's discounted, I don't know, 55% or something for whatever their value is. Just consider that maybe that's worth doing or not.
Yeah. Or I don't know, you know, maybe the bubble is cheaper. I don't know. Yeah. So I haven't looked at that. I just been saving them up, especially that 5-day, cause I knew we weren't going to get another one like that. So, okay. But yeah, do this first. It unlocks everything. And then the next thing I would do, next slide. And the reason I put this up is not that I think this is the first priority to do. It's actually a low priority thing to do because we don't have any turrets. We don't have any turrets that outweigh everything. So the only reason I put this up as a secondary one is if you are close to your maximum number of 3-day defense platform upgrade tokens, because you max out at 10, go ahead and spend those down. Because right now we have the power play, which is going to give you 5 more. So you don't want to be wasting those while you have other upgrades going on.
Especially with the effort it's going to take to get those.
Yeah. So yeah, you don't want to be spilling those into the water. So I would do this as the secondary one. Do not spend real time on it, but spend your tokens down and then accrue them through the rest of the year until the next OP-14 or OP-15 upgrade. So, any other thoughts on that where we can move on? Okay, let's move on. Dock 18, Hay 18 is going to be, it's going to be necessary in order to use more than 3 fully built purifiers in the next raid. They've been telling us it's going to be 3 is what it's tuned for. But historically you were significantly better off with 5. It really depends on what your build token situation is, your structure build token situation is, and you know, other things, but yeah, you can only really fit 3 in there. So that would be the first thing I'd do after I get my OP upgraded and you spend the tokens on the defense platform. So, okay. But otherwise, you're going to be spending especially if you don't have an officer. 24 plus what this one's probably 17.
16 or 17, one of the two.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's going to be, the next raid's going to be over, especially if you're getting hit by people. Yeah, it could be the next raid before, you know, you may not even get them all done, you know, get your dock done before the second raid in the cycle.
Right.
So, I wish they had a smoother way to do this. I recall, does anybody remember how many years ago it was that they allowed your upgrade workers to continue to work when the building was damaged?
I feel like it was last year, was it? Or was it two?
I think it was two.
Yeah, it was. Well, I don't think it was last year. And I'm not even sure. It might have been. It was at least 2 or 3 years ago. I don't think it was last year. But I think it would be a good move because this is, it's an awkward type of thing to ask the players to plan on X, Y, and Z. And yeah, it's, and it probably, if you drop a bunker buster on, well, it automatically repairs at this point. So yeah, that doesn't even matter. Cause I remember back in the day, you know, people that were real dicks would just drop a bunker buster on somebody's dock to prevent things from upgrading. But yeah, but now you would need to kill the entire base. So just, yeah, or on their outpost. And then you wouldn't even start repairing until the person logged back in again. So, mm-hmm. Yeah, people were dicks. So, all right. And let's move on. All right, the rest of these I have is part of a large group. I don't really personally suggest one over another.
The one you should do is whatever has the most build time on your ship. So if your purifier has 5 days worth of weapon refits on, and only 2 days worth of armor refits on, do the weapon one first. I don't know.
Yeah, what those, but I think by the time. Well, the thing I would probably do is the one that does the upgrade, because I think by the time that we get to, most people get to this, it's going to be, it's the intelligence lab. I think that would be the first priority, because I think by the time that most people reach this, they're going to have their purifiers built. And so more it's going to be about upgrading them than building them. But, yeah, we'll see. It's going to vary for each individual. But if you notice, you'll see that you see ship weapon refit modifiers for at the top is 0 to 99. So that stays as a constant until the game runs. You know, they've already shown us when the game ends up. You know, an 89 or no,
90, 89, 88 years, something like that.
Yeah, 80 and a half years, the game's going to be over with. So, you know, just keep that in mind if you're doing the long play with your structure build tokens. You might
all wanna... these young whippersnappers coming into the game at this point. I've been around here longer than all you, longer than dirt.
Yeah, so the 30 will stay around for a good long time. Then you see 20% refit time modifier for tier up to tier 9.5, and then we see 10 to 10.5, and then we see that the 11 to 11.5 is only negative 10 because this is a three-step process. The 6 day, 7 hours is going to be a 10% reduction. And then it gets a little bit longer, I think. And then it's going to go from 10 to 15. And then it gets a little bit longer yet. And then it goes from 15 to 20. My recommendation is to do the first level because you're getting more bang for your buck out of your time because you're going from 0 to 10 as opposed to, you know, spending even more time to go from 10 to 15 because, unless we decide that, you know, once we get to the upgrade one, which I'm not sure has the same modifier.
Upgrade's actually just 5, 10, 15, if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Yeah. So, yeah, the intelligence lab is, 5, 10, 15. So, maybe you choose to do that. first and then do the rest of them, but then you're still, I don't know, because you're probably going to be upgrading these while you're, or you're going to be upgrading these buildings while you're upgrading your purifiers. So therefore, at the end of the day, I don't know how much it matters, because yeah, you've gotten your upgrade time modifier down to negative 15, but now you're back in the build session again. So,
Do you want to back up to those other ones or that I shot through?
Yeah, we can just quickly go through them.
We were here. Okay, so now we're going to go to Naval Lab.
Yeah.
That's your armor.
Yeah. Yeah, so this is for the armor. Same story.
Advanced Lab for your specials.
Yep, yep. Same story. We can move on.
Intel Lab, we just talked about.
Yep.
And Tactical Lab.
Tactical Lab is another three-step process. Is it a three-step process or a four-step process? And this one requires your other labs to be upgraded. And this one...
That's that 5% seems wrong. It should it be 10, 15, and 20 like the others?
Yeah, it does. It doesn't feel right. I'll ask about that. Let's see. One second. Quick screenshot. All righty. And or you can move on. But again, that has prerequisites that you need to have all the other ones up to the, at least the first level before that one can be. All right, the retrofit lab, I put this one last. You know, does the 10%, does the 10% make a huge difference in your Conqueror, Defender, or Interceptors?
Nope.
Not terribly, no.
I don't even think that it changes how many coins it is from 2 or 3 or anything. It might, but...
Yeah. Okay. All right, let's move on. Conquest Yard 6. Even though this does come from your Conquest Yard, and I think there's some text missing out of this, like what happened with building tiers. Unless they made some big changes. I think there's something wrong here, because before it was... 0 to 10, did they take away that as far as, because this building damage, even though it comes out of the Conquest Yard, applies to all your ships. I don't think this is written correctly.
It does seem like something is off. Yeah.
Yeah. But this is useful. It not only impacts your PvP, your Conquerors and Defenders, it also impacts your purifiers, your dragoons, your whatever, your brutes. So it is useful, even though it does take a good amount of time. But this is a one step, you know, it's 13 days.
And in the past, there has been some TLCs that have had Conquest Yard upgrade tokens as part of that. Can't think of names offhand, but I still have a couple tokens left.
Yeah, I do as well. Yeah, so something eventually comes out for that.
Right.
So I would wait around for that one. Okay, and let's move on to the next one. Saw Factory 3. 12 days. All it does is unlock the Lake Fire Mine, which is still a broken stat block. In so many ways.
I think there's information missing here too, because I think I saw that it was supposed to increase the amount of mines you can hold.
Okay. In your
inventory. So I don't know if that they call it weight or what they call it, but anyway, I think that went along with it.
Okay, well, let's get rid of one more click. Let's get rid of some of the nonsense. All right, that was just complete nonsense. And you can see it on the other ones if you still want to see it. But that needs to be removed. I mean, as far as these deflection, it doesn't matter.
Right. I mean, it's all it's just saying is that an attacker can't destroy the mine by shooting at it.
Yes. And they can't even see it. So it's not even really relevant. And it's, you know, But what this they
can see it now. Actually, I've been hitting a few bases, and I've been seeing green mines before I run over them.
Huh. Okay.
I haven't seen any of those red ones, and the blue ones are still invisible before I hit them. But something's changed with some of these mines.
That doesn't seem right, but okay.
All right. The first thing that's the trigger range on all these says 120, and they've continued since the beginning of the Saw Factory to show a trigger range of 120. The range is actually 12, but they've yet to change it.
Why is it 12? I thought it was divided by 5.
I have no idea. I have no idea why it's. I mean, I was told who was when these first came out. It was saltwater. Braden. Right?
Well, saltwater and Braden, yeah.
Saltwater, yeah. And we were told it was 12 on Discord. So I'm going with 12. I mean, as opposed to 24.
I remember something about what Derby was saying, though. A divided by 5 factor something. There was
Yeah, that used to be in a lot of things. You know, spread was a big one. As far as the specials that you had, as far as the display you had in your turret specials, that was in there. But yeah, normally it was divided by 5. But this one, at least I was told by the GD that it was the actual trigger range was 12. I mean, in game, does it feel like 12 or 24?
Feels more like 24, to be honest.
Okay.
Closer to.
All right. Which is interesting because if it's triggered that far away, and you have like, if you take, I'm comparing it to the anti-ship mine, that does corrosive damage. You know, it's, you're still, you know, if it's getting triggered at 24 and it already has a range of 30, you're automatically taking. I don't even understand that one. Does that one look right to you as far as the way the one on the right is written, either one of you? I mean, because it has a duration of 1.56, but it has a total damage, as opposed to if you take a look at the lake fire mine.
Yeah, it looks like this one's a damage over time.
Yeah, it's like it has a DOT metric.
Spread damage.
Yeah, but that one has a duration as well.
That shouldn't have a duration. I mean.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Something looks wrong. I did get confirmation that the click rate on the lake fire mine is every 0.2 seconds.
Okay, so it should be taking down 40 million, doing 40 million radioactive damage every 0.2 seconds if you're within.
No. It's 8
per second. Was 40 million per second.
So it's 8.
To be 8 million per every fifth of a second.
Yeah, and that's when it applies the damage. It applies the damage every 0.2 seconds, and it'll inflict 8 million damage. So this one has a duration of 20 seconds. And so every 0.2 seconds, it's inflicting 8 million damage. And we have not, you know, at one point this was counted, this was impacted by deflection, but now it's not. Is that true? Or
it was announced that deflection wasn't supposed to work, but it does work on the green one as of a few months ago.
Okay.
I assume, I am very confident it still deflection works against the damage over time.
Okay. All right.
And you know, the green one doesn't exactly have a big blast radius range to it either. And this has even got a smaller one. 40 versus 30.
But it doesn't have, but it has a range as opposed to a splash. I don't know. somebody needs to go down and sit with these mind stat blocks, because they are overly confusing and they appear to be conflicting. So this is a range, not a splash, so it's not going to have any fall off associated with it. And then I assume splash, dispersion arm, you know, that stuff doesn't work. So this is more
it's
of a...
It's a damage over time field. So, yeah.
Yeah. But, yeah. And then, you know, the other one has a damage over time stats associated, you know, duration and whatnot. So, yeah. Somebody needs to sit down with these and have a stern talking to them about their confusing nature. So, all right, I put this lower down on the list. I'm not sure this is going to be. It seems like it's more interesting as far as how to, you know, it's more logical where you would put this, you know, right next to your ice walls and whatnot, or firing range of your ice walls to force them to sit inside of this range over that time period. So, all right. Any more on Saw Factory 3?
Not for me.
Okay. All right. Let's move on. Portal 7, 18 days.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Lovely, lovely.
18 days, 20 without an officer, and you've got three of these guys.
Yep. And they take forever to repair, just like an OP when you get hit.
Yep. And at this point, we don't have any anything to put on them that's new that would overcome the power capacity, which isn't that much, but I'm sure it's going to be whatever drops is going to be 87 naked, you know, or something like that. Yeah.
So, some new trap.
Yeah. Yeah, this is
you know, they don't like people to use the word paywall because it's not strictly a paywall, but it's a functional kind of a paywall in a way.
Yeah. So
yeah, I'll say that despite how I dislike how KickSide makes their makes offers like this, portals with way too long a build time and doesn't let them repair while they're doesn't let them repair and upgrade at the same time. I plan to buy the LTO for this when it comes out, if it's under $40. I mean, it's going to save me, you know, 2 months of upgrade time, maybe three if I get flat. Yeah. And I'm not going to start upgrading a single portal until I see that.
It's a massive pain point. There's no question.
Yeah.
And my plan always as a budget player has been I save up the 2-day tokens and whatever else I'm maxed up, and then boom, I'll do it so that I only have a minimum amount of downtime from it.
Yeah, and I would add on to that, because you know you're going to be upgrading your labs and everything else over that time period, is I would wait to a point in time where, if it ever happens again, where the meta switches more to defense, and that way you're less likely to be impacted by the repair time.
The meta switches more to defense if you go in these things.
Yes, but if you're not planning to wait for that to coin the change, I might wait. If you're doing everything else, I might wait until it appears like it's slid to the defensive side. That way, you don't have to wait for that repair in order to continue on with your upgrade. So, all good. This is the last of the slides. Derpy, you want to hit the new target, or you're repairing from
Yeah, I can hit the new target. The fleet won't be 100% fresh, but
you taking me out present?
Yeah, well, as soon as he comes up.
Okay. Just let me know when.
Okay.
All right.
I've gotten back to the technical lab, a tactical lab in regards to evade that could be an oversight, and that might be it might be 10, 15, 20. No, all right, I switched over, but just as a heads up, that stat might change.
Okay.
All right, here's the 223. You can actually auto this target, which is really nice. There's no turrets behind the mountains. I don't know why there were in Village in the first place. And it looks like everything's pretty similar to what we've seen in the past. So I don't have an exact pattern or timing stuff figured down. So let's just kill this first sub and hope it doesn't go underwater right when I attack it. That guy's down. I'll just go around the outside, stay moving over these rocket turrets, and just try and skim them. It should take out the whole cluster pretty easy. Once all the projectiles have landed, you can cut in, go grab the brimstone, etc. Just move by these guys.
Any knuckle dusters on your fleet, by the way?
I do not. I have them. I have bought them in the raid, but I need to wait for my purifier to finish going to U2 before equipping them.
So what I had going on, I didn't have time to get them. So,
tricky point there. Just got caught by the slowdown field at the same time as some of those rockets. And I think I was actually 223 damage before starting this. I probably should have checked more, but again, these rockets, I'm not going to cut in. I'm just going to go diagonal straight up here. Just clip the edge and keep going. So these buildings and stuff still die really fast. It seems like you can, again, be a pretty reasonable driving target for sure.
Yeah, yeah. It looks much easier than what we're going to have to deal with the lionfish.
Yeah. Anyway, you know, 28% resisted, 7% taken for explosive. Penetrative has 3% taken, 11% resisted. Damage, that looks like to be just over an hour. Although, okay, again, I didn't actually track that too well. So
that jives with what KB said earlier, where he said he was getting, I think, right about an hour for driving these targets.
Yep. So pretty reasonable to drive for sure. Like I said, 3 hours damage if you auto it. So that's not great. But I can't even afford a single CIC yet. So, oh well. Just got to figure out what I want to buy. I think this Ironhide's a new addition, by the way.
Okay.
I did not. I thought I didn't buy one of these structure build tokens already yet. Huh. Oh well. I mean, target's not horrible. So,
yeah.
That's all there is.
Okay. Alrighty.
And if you look in the top left, ignore the gold. Just I have dumped my metals down to 359, so I get hit less often while my output is upgrading. So
is anybody particular now that you dumped your metals that you're going to go after?
Nope.
Are you sure you don't want to, you know, let us know?
Oh, I might go hit Popeye or something.
Okay. I thought he was on your list after watching you two in Discord that, you know.
There is some very much game playing going on with that. Actually, a friend of mine got hit by somebody that had all the latest stuff, whatever else, and had a zero metal count when it hit him. Mm-hmm. I'm like, uh-huh, sure, yeah.
I just dropped to people don't hit me, so I'm not attempting target. But, yeah.
But now you announced it.
Yeah.
I don't know strategically. Strategically, I wouldn't have announced that, but yeah.
I'm just trying to give the same tip to other people who watch the show.
Okay. That makes more sense, but yeah. Yeah, because I used to have, like, you know, if you have two, what do you think the sweet spot is at this point in time? I assume you think it's around 350, where
No,
but I was thinking, like, If you're an alliance, and if you have too few metals, people are going to try and farm you on Mondays, right?
They can
but
try.
Then if you have too many medals, yeah, yeah, okay. You're not listening to my question. But what do you think listening. The sweet spot is? Okay. If you have too few medals, you make yourself a target for people trying to get alliance points. But if you have too many, people are going to be going after you just to get medals or brag or whatnot. So what do you consider like the range that I guess your range is going all the way down to zero is the
yeah,
answer?
I really don't have much of an idea, but if I drop to zero medals, someone tries to hit me for easy alliance points, they're going to give me some. I'm going to go back up. So it doesn't really matter because you'll get to the right equilibrium anyway. But that's what I think.
Yeah, because they're still going to get alliance points. They're just not going to get medals. So that's, yeah, so somewhere around that 300, 350 range or 350 to 375 is you're not going to get, okay, 175 to 230 according to LIGO.
Okay, well, I'm going to have to come donate some of mine to LIGO. We'll
see. Yeah, go dump some medals on LIGO.
Yeah, let me go find them.
And I think there's
I'm gonna have to take out, well, maybe I'll have to, if I'll give him, I'll hit him twice, give him a bunch, and then go flatten him the third time so I take some away and, you know, keep him happy, let his outpost prepare for 12 more hours.
Yeah, yeah, you know, that's one possibility. But okay. Yeah, he dumped his medals to zero many times. So, alrighty. Is anybody in chat? I assume that nobody on the show has hit the power play yet. I'm assuming we've been using a working assumption.
You're wrong.
Oh, you've already hit it? Is it the same? It's the same as Brutal Instinct?
I don't remember. I think so.
you can't remember a target.
No, there are a bunch of lionfish targets. I don't know exactly which ones they are, but I just drove to the halo, killed that, and pressed S, and I got roughly 4.5 hours damage on my fleet. So, well, 5.5 maybe.
Okay. All right. So, yeah, if anybody in chat that's hit it that would remember what the previous targets look like, let us know. And because we're working with the assumption that that's the case. So, all right. Any other things that we should be telling people?
No, I got nothing.
Okay. Derpy, everybody needs to I'm using my 9.5 to 10.5 siege ships. Basically it's, you know, if you have right now, if you have caught up with the game, as far as getting titanium, base parts, even uranium, you can send anything from 9.5 to 10.5 to 11 and just auto them. You send all three out and get to the limited resources that you need to upgrade. Whatever, it's not really all that difficult, so just keep that in mind, everybody. They all get it. Some get it done for like a second, some take like a minute and a half, and some take 3 minutes, but they're all instant repair in the water. So and Scouts in the Sky is I guess if he's growing metals because he's a metal farm. So if you want to dump metals on him, he's up for that.
He can always use more metal seeds.
Mm-hmm. So, All righty, everybody. I guess we'll be back on Friday for VXP weekend, which is hopefully an easy one. Well, I guess I'm going to send the invite out in case anybody wants to join the show or the after show. That's there. Damn, because I did that, I forgot what was I introing? Oh, we'll be on Friday and we'll talk about VXP weekend because I assume it's going to be fairly easy. Because hopefully, because these are siege targets and so everything is stationary, so you should be able to go in with your conquerors, take out anything that fires, and then, you know, if necessary, and then come in with your purifiers or whatnot, and then take out the innocent buildings that can't fire at you. So, but we'll see. But I suspect that's going to be the case.
That's usually the case with siege ones. You're right about that.
Yeah. So much easier than skirmish because they're everything. Nope, nothing's moving. So everything's static. All righty. I guess we'll see you all then. And take care, everybody. And best of luck with FM and Power Play. And again, as a reminder, if I can figure out how to do it, only subscribers are going to be able to chat, just so I don't have to deal with the nonsense, and see if that works. So
that's just FA's way of trying to get more subscribers.
Yeah.
I was paid by Kixi for how many subscribers he did.
And I'm assuming Derpy is the Russian hacker that's after us.
Yeah, definitely.
That's broadcasting on the show.
Actually, I'm pulling my hackers back as we speak. You might think there's more of them, but there's really fewer.
Well, I'm assuming it's not an actual hacker, but a bot. But yeah, it's. I'm assuming that they're not going to, but you know, as Tax Cut says, it's. Well, as he said earlier, even Russian hacker subs matter. So it's all good. So later, people, and we will see you on Friday. And thanks again for showing up. And later.
See ya.